It was announced from Sandringham that the King passed peacefully away in his sleep earlier this morning.
God save the Queen!
When I spoke to you last, I asked you all, whatever your religion, to pray for me on the day of my coronation. To pray that God would give me wisdom and strength to carry out the promises that I should then be making. Throughout this memorable day, I have been uplifted and sustained by the knowledge that your thoughts and prayers were with me. I have been aware all the time that my peoples spread far and wide throughout every continent and ocean in the world were united to support me in the task to which I have now been dedicated with such solemnity. I have in sincerity pledged myself to your service, as so many of you are pledged to mine. Throughout all my life and with all my heart, I shall strive to be worthy of your trust. In this resolve, I have my husband to support me. He shares all my ideals and all my affection for you. Then, although my experience is so short and my task so new, I have in my parents and grandparents an example which I can follow with certainty and with confidence. As this day draws to its close, I know that my abiding memory of it will be not only the solemnity and beauty of the ceremony, but the inspiration of your loyalty and affection. I thank you all from a full heart. God bless you all. When I was 21, I pledged my life to the service of our people, and I asked for God's help to make good that vow. Although that vow was made in my salad days when I was green in judgment, I do not regret nor retract one word of it.
Says, Christ grew in wisdom and understanding. He began his task of explaining and teaching just what it is that God wants from us. The two lessons that he had for us, which he underlined in everything he said and did, are the messages of God's love and how essential it is that we too should love other people. There are many serious and threatening problems in this country and in the world, but they will never be solved until there is peace in our homes and love in our hearts. The message which God sent us is a very simple one.
Make love your goal.
Above all, to declare my resolve to continue, with the support of my family, to serve the people of this great nation of ours to the best of my ability through the changing times ahead. We have much to do together to build a future for all our grandchildren. The kind of future our grandparents could only dream of.
Today this could be the greatest day.